Hey guys, welcome to I'm Path Gaming. So today we are back with another video. In this video I will talk about top 10 games from Steam Game Festival. No Place for Bravery is a 2D top-down action RPG where you play as Thorn, an ambitious warrior who is in search for his lost daughter. The unique and beautiful visuals are designed with highly detailed pixel art. The soundtrack is really good. And the combat is intense. You will have to timely parry to defeat your enemies. As per the Steam page, the game will release in 2021. Undying is a top-down survival game with a real day-night cycle. The low-poly art style is beautiful and suits the game. In Undying, you play as Enling, who is infected by a zombie bite. Her days are numbered, she has to fight and survive the apocalypse. And teach her son everything so that he can survive alone as well. As per the Steam page, the game will be released in summer 2021. Hazel Sky is an adventure game about a young engineer facing his destiny and his desire. The main character is a young boy who must learn and repair an airplane and fly towards a flying city. The demo was short, which was a bit disappointing, but the game looks nice and unique. As per the Steam page, the game has planned to be released in 2021. Shady Knight is a first-person melee action full of dynamic interactive fights and fluid platforming. You will climb through a tower defeating various enemies, kicking them on spike and fire, or slicing them with a sword. The game is fast-paced and perfect for speedrunners. As per the Steam page, currently no release date is decided for the game. Slender Threads is a point-and-click adventure thriller. It's about Harvey, an unremarkable traveling salesman who somehow comes to a town where there are mysteries which he tries to uncover. In Slender Threads, you get to interact with a variety of characters, solve challenging puzzles, and uncover the hidden mysteries. As per the Steam page, the game has planned to be released in 2021. Genesis Noir is a game about a love triangle between cosmic beings. The jealous god shoots a gun, which resulted in a big bang. The artwork got my attention, and the gameplay got me hooked to the game. It's more of an art piece than a game. Again, it is something that should be experienced. As per the Steam page, Genesis Noir will be released in quarter 1 of 2021. The Last Stand Aftermath is a single-player roguelite action-adventure in which you become infected by a zombie virus and you use your last few days in finding gathering supplies for the fellow survivor. The concept is interesting as you get to play as different character and eventually you die by a zombie or infection. After each death, you will play as a new character. Another interesting thing is, whenever the infection grows, you can select one perk out of three choices, which makes playing as an infected more fun. Labyrinth is a puzzle game in which a metric-based AI will monitor profile and entertain you while you progress through the puzzles. The game offers challenging puzzles, and the addition of AI narrator makes the experience more fun.
100% of testers described this puzzle as impossibly difficult. Good luck.
What's more interesting is that you will view and contribute to in-game analytics that is updated in real time with real player data. For example, displaying how many players have solved a particular puzzle makes it more competitive experience. As per the Steam page, the game will be released in 2021. Happy Game is a game about a little boy who falls asleep to a horrible nightmare. The Happy Game has such a beautiful art style and interesting puzzle and horror element that a lot of horror game lacks. This one brought a lot of emotion in me. It started with happy, then scary, and turned creepy real quickly. As per the Steam page, the game will be released in spring 2021. Hidden Deep is a 2D action and exploration sci-fi thriller in which the action takes place about 1.6 km under the ocean floor. A group of researchers detected some strange anomaly of unknown nature and organized an expedition to examine the mysterious phenomenon. What grabbed most of my attention in the game is that it offers a lot of unique game mechanics and is fun to play. You can do things like command a team of up to 4 players, operate different equipments. So that is it for today, guys. Thanks for watching. Be kind, be safe, and have a good one.